Hello friends, welcome to my channel English with Shaganaloda. Friends, this is a session for your checking of preparations for UGC NET SAT examination. I have come with 20 MCQs on English literature. I hope you will enjoy in solving them. My first MCQ is the Subjugation of Women, 1869, is an important text of A. George Eliot, B. Byron, C. John Mead, D. Hartig. And the answer is C. John Mill. John Mill was also famous for his philosophy of utilitarianism. My second question is, which of the following poems by Tennyson is a monodrama? A. Ulysses, B. Break, 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 C. Maud, D. Crossing the Bars. And you know, Ulysses is a dramatic monologue, Break, Break, Break is a short elegy. C. Maud is right answer for this question, that this is a monodrama penned down by Tennyson. My next question is, the line, she dwells with beauty, beauty that must be a cursing. Keats, A. Lamia, B. Ode to a Grecian Iron, C. Ode on Melancholy, D. Endymion. And these famous lines occur in C. Ode on Melancholy. My fourth question, negative capability to Keats mean A. The ability to sympathize with others, B. Say bad things about others, C. To criticize, and D. To emphasize. And the answer is B. To emphasize. Best example of negative capability according to Keats is William Shakespeare. Keats also gave a term, negative capability, and Keats also gives some more terms which we will discuss in our other videos. Number 5, art for art's sake found its true adherent in A. Wordsworth, B. Byron, C. Browning, and D. White. Byron, the answer is D. Oscar Wilde. Oscar Wilde's famous novel The Picture of Dorian Gray was famous for art's sake movement. Wordsworth was worshipper of nature. Lord Byron and Lord Browning both were different type of persons. They were not true adherent of art for art's sake movement. My sixth question is, it is the best of time, it was the worst of time, it was the worst. These famous opening lines of Dickens' novel. This question was also asked in UGC NET exam. A. Hard Time, B. David Copperfield, C. Oliver Twist, and D. A Tale of Two Cities. And the answer is D. A Tale of Two Cities. I have also made a video on A Tale of Two Cities. You can also search him and watch him. 7. The character of Little Nell is a creation of A. Hardy, B. Eliot, C. Oscar Wilde, D. Dickens. And the answer is D. Dickens. 8. Idylls of the King is illustration of Tennyson's deep interest in A. Medieval legends, B. The role of king, C. Hero worship, D. The contemporary condition. And the answer of this question is 8B, the role of the king. Idylls of King was based on King Arthur, because Victorians were not interested in their contemporary condition. So Tennyson found his inspiration in medieval legends, King Arthur. My ninth question for you is, who believed that poetry is the spontaneous overflow of emotions. And as everybody knows, that this was a famous definition given by William Wordsworth in preface of Lyrical Ballad. Answer is C, Wordsworth. 10th, who after the publication of a poem awoke and found himself famous? This was famously said by Browning to his wife, that one day when I woke, I found myself famous. Answer is B, Browning. 11th question. The age of fame fatal dominates the poetry of A, Wordsworth, B, Keats, C, Byron, D, Tennyson. Fame fatal means a beautiful lady which destroyed his lover. And as you all know, Wordsworth was worshipper of nature. Nature never destroys. Tennyson was inspired from medieval legends. Lord Byron was not a lover of female. So, remaining B, John Keats, right answer for this question. 12th, Little Time is a character in Hardy's. A, The Return of the Native, B, Jude the Obscure, C, Mayor of Casterbridge, D, Test the Arbor Valleys. And this question was also asked in UGC NET exam. 12th, B, Jude the Obscure. Little Time is a famous character in Jude the Obscure. My 13th question for you, which is the famous elegy written by Shelley, In Memoriam, Lycidas, Adonis, Thyrsis? In Memoriam was written by Wright, Tennyson. Lycidas was written by Milton. Adonis was written by Shelley on Keats. Thyrsis was written by Matthew Arnold. I have also made a video on great elegies in English literature. You can also watch that video for more detailed description. 14th question. The moral choice is everything in the works of A. Dickens, B. George Eliot, C. Hardy. And the answer is A. Dickens, because Dickens was a Victorian novelist. 15th. Which of the following is illustrative of Ruskin's interest in social economy? A. The Seven Lamps, B. Unto This Last, C. The Stones of Venice, and D. All of Me. This question's answer is B, Unto This Last. Unto This Last has also an Indian connection. Mahatma Gandhi was also impressed from this Unto This Last. 16th question. Which one of the following poet named the romantic poets as pond poets or lake poets? Answer A, Robert Southey, B, Shelley, C, Keats, D, Byron. And the answer is A, Robert Southey. Lake poets were famously Wordsworth, Coleridge, and Shelley. Lake poets were famously Wordsworth, Coleridge, and some other counts in them. Lamb was also a lake inhabitant. So my next question for you is, The Charge of the Light Brigade, written by Tennyson, commentates on A, Boer War, B, Battle of Trafalgar, C, Crimean War, D, the Boer War. And the answer is C, the Crimean War. It was a very famous poem by Tennyson on Crimean War. 18th, the Elysian Marble inspired Keats to write A, Endymion, B, Lamia, C, Grecian, and D, Melancholy. And the answer of this is, the Elgin Marble inspired Keats to write the Grecian. You can also remember that urn was made of marble, so the answer should be Elgin marble. 19th question. Would you tell Sordello, which was written by Browning as a number A, dramatic monologue, B, dramatic lyric, C, tragic drama, D, drama? And the answer was B, dramatic lyric. Sordello was notorious work of Browning, which was very tough to understand. Even Tennyson could not understand that. 20th question. Which of the following poet was appointed poet laureate in the year 1803? And the answer is C, Robert Southey. Robert Southey was appointed as poet laureate in year 1803. Friends, I hope you enjoy this journey. Thank you very much. Have a good day.